Hey everyone, so welcome back to my channel again. In this video, we are going to discuss how to solve 98 raised to the power 5. It is very, very important to understand how we are solving an exponent using a combination. Also, we are using the binomial theorem here because we are writing this 98 as 100 minus 2. It is very, very important. So we are using two things. First, we are using combination. So first we are using the combination and also we are using the binomial theorem to solve this question. 98 raised to the power 5 means you are multiplying 98 5 times. If you are normally multiplying 98 5 times, it will not be conducive for you. It is a time consuming method. Second, there is a chance that you can do a mistake, and if you are a higher grade student, you can't do 98 multiply 98 multiply 98 multiply, which is not expected from you. So please understand how to use the binomial theorem in this, how we are converting this 98 as a binomial expression. So we are converting this 98 as 100 minus 2. It will become a binomial term because there are two terms. Now 100 minus 2 raised to the power 5, we are solving using combination, which is NCR, that is equals to factorial N divided by factorial R into N minus R factorial. Okay. Second thing, you have to understand how to solve a factorial. If N is 5, then 5 factorial means 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Okay, into means multiplication. 5 multiply 4 multiply 3 multiply 2 multiply 1. So please go through the complete video so that you can understand how we are solving the question. And calculation is very, very easy. Go through the video slowly. And when you are solving it by yourself, do your steps very slowly. Okay, it will take time to understand this. So go very carefully. So yes, let's start the video, everyone. So let's compute this question using binomial theorem. So how we will do it? So let me bifurcate the page first. Now please see it very carefully how to do this question. Okay. 98 raised to the power 5, you can, if you are a small child of class 5th or 4th or 3rd, 98 raised to the power 5 means 98 times 98 times 98 times 98. 5 times 98. But it will be difficult for you to multiply every time with such a big number. So what we will do here, we will use the binomial theorem to solve it, because in higher classes, expansion of these type, you can solve using binomial theorem. So binomial, from the name itself, using binomial theorem, what is binomial? Binomial means two terms. Binomial means two terms. So first I have to make this 98 in the form of two terms. So how I will write 98? I will write it as 100 minus 2. Okay. Now this will become a binomial expression. 100 minus 2, because there are two terms. One is 100 and one is 2. Raised to the power 5. So solving a binomial expression with some positive integral power. How to solve it? Please understand. Using combination. Yes. Permutation combination. What combination means, like, we have to use NCR. NCR means factorial N, N minus R factorial and factorial R, right? N means there are N terms. There are five combination. And how means total, total number is 5. And how you are arranging them is R. Right. So how you will write this? NCR means factorial N divided by factorial R divided by the multiply N minus R factorial. So N is the total numbers you have. Okay. Total amount, total objects, you can say. N is the total objects, and R means the combination, the total combination you can make out of N objects. Right. So this is the formula. Please remember this. This will help you to solve this question, right? Now, what you have to do,
You have to write, because here the total number is 5. Total objects are 5. So what you have to do, you have total 5 objects and you have to make R combinations to solve it. So now what we are going to do, please see. So 100 minus 2 raised to the power 5 is equals to. So what is NCR? N is 5. So starting from 5C0. Then write 5C1 with some gap, 5C2, 5C3, then 5C4, and then 5C5. Okay, up till here you have written. Now, because there is a minus in between, so every second term is of minus. If the between sign is of minus, then every second term is a minus. So second, fourth, and then sixth. Otherwise, all are positive. Okay, every second term, if the middle sign is of minus between the two terms, then every second term is of minus. Now what we will do after writing this, what we have to do, we have to write the first term with the decreasing order power and second term with the increasing order power, like 100 raised to the power 5, then decreasing 4, then decreasing 3, then decreasing 2, then decreasing 1, and then 0. Right? Similarly with 2, second term. So second term with increasing power, 0, then 1, then 2, then 3, then 4, and last one is 5. Okay? Last one is 2 raised to the power 5. Now, after that, what we have to do? So, 100 minus 2 raised to the power 5. Let's solve it. How to solve? Let's start with the first one. How to solve 5C0? 5C0 means factorial 5 divided by n minus r means 5 minus 0 factorial and r means 0 factorial. Always remember 0 factorial values always equals to 1. This I will tell you in another video why 0 factorial is 1. But please remember that 0 factorial is equals to 1. So what is left? 5 factorial divided by 5 factorial into 1. So 5 factorial cancel out. Numerator with the denominator. What is left? 1 only left. So 1 multiply 100 raised to the power 5. And 2 raised to the power 0 is 1 only, because something raised to the power 0 means 1. Now let's move with the second one. 5C1. Here 5C1. So we will just remove 0. So 5C1 means 5 factorial, 5 minus 1 factorial and 1 factorial. So 5 factorial and 4 factorial, because 5 minus 1 is 4 and 1 factorial means 1 only. Now how to solve this? How you are writing some factorials, just multiply. 5 factorial means 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. You just have to multiply all the natural numbers before 5 with 5, right? So 5 you have written, and before 5, what number, natural numbers are there? 4, 3, 2, 1, multiply all them. Similarly, 4 factorial means what? 4 multiply the number before, the natural number before 4 is 3, 2, 1. So write like this. Now 4, 3, 2, 1, cancel out with 4, 3, 2, 1. What is left? Only 5 is left. Then 100 raised to the power 4 and 2 raised to the power 1 is 2. Now moving with the third one. 5 factorial 2. So let's solve this one. Now it is very important to understand how to solve this. 5 factorial 2. 5 factorial, 2 factorial and 5 minus 2 factorial. So 5 factorial divided by 2 factorial means 2 into 1. And 5 minus 2 factorial means 3 factorial. So 3 factorial. Now how to solve it? 5 factorial means 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 divided by 2 into 1, we have written 2, and 3 factorial means 3 into 2. So what, how can solve it? 3, 2, 3, 2 cancel out, then 2 times 2 and 10. So it is 10. So 10, and what is in multiplication with this? 5C2, 100 raised to power 3 and 2 raised to power 2 means 4. Now 5C2 is always equals to 5C3. So it is also 10. So you can solve it and easily you will get that 5C3 is equals to 5C2. which is equals to 10 only. Okay, so don't get panicked that why I have written it as 10. Then into 100 raised to the power 2 and 2 raised to the power 3 means 8. 8. Now moving towards the next part, plus 5c4. What is 5c1, which is equals to 5c4? So 5c4 you can easily solve out. That is factorial 5 divided by 4 factorial and 5 minus 4 factorial. So 5 factorial divided by 4 factorial into 1 factorial. 1 factorial means 1 only. 5 factorial means 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. And 4 factorial means 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. 4, 3, 2, 1. 4, 3, 2, 1. Cancel out. What is left with 5 into 100 into 2 raised to the power 4 means 16. 5C5 means 1 only. Okay, 1. 1 into 100 raised to the power 0 is 1. And into 2 raised to the power 5, which is 32. So 1 into 32 is 32. So this is we are left with. Now we have to solve this. Now we have to solve this. So I'm just removing this one because I have just the values now to solve. Simple values. So let me solve it here only. So what is left? 100 minus 2 raised to the power 5, which is equals to 100 raised to the power 5 means 5 times you have to write 2 zeros. Means 10 zero you have to write. So 2, 2, 2, 2 and 2. Minus 5 into 2 is 10. 10 into 100 raised to the power 4 means 8 zeros you have to write. So don't write multiply, just write 8 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Right? Then solve this one. So plus 40 with 6 zeros. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 minus. Solve this one. So 4 zeros with 1 0 and 80. So 8. Plus 16 into 5 is what? 80. And 80 with 2 zeros and minus 32. Now you have to solve it. Now you have to solve it. Right? So I'm just removing it to make you understand how to solve these values. So we are left with this. Just a second. So let me solve these values. So 100 minus 2 raised to the power 5 is equals to. Now you have to solve it. How many zeros are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 zeros are there. So 8 zeros you can write. Because these are 10 and these are how much? 9. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And this. Right? Then you have to solve these two. So how many zeros? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 up till here. And then 2, 9, 3. And plus 8,000 minus 32, which is 8. 9 minus 3 is 6, 9 and 7. And so we are left with these numbers. We just have to add them. So the final answer is 9, 7, 9, 6, 8. You just have to add them. So 4, so 0, 2, 3, 9, 4, 8 and 9, 0. So this is your final answer. Okay. So this is how you will solve the question using the binomial expansion. Okay, so you can solve a binomial expression with some positive integral power or index, like using the combination, right? So yeah, thank you everyone. Thank you so much. And please learn how to solve NCR, right? It's very important. We will go more with NCR when we will doing that permutation and combination chapter, right? So yeah, thank you everyone.